Praise the Lord, saints. My name is Pastor Evangelist Deborah Tate. I'm with Royal Diadem Internet Ministry, and we are the Crown Gem of Cleveland, Ohio. And if you're watching this, it's because you're trying to maybe get a degree in something, and or you're trying to further your biblical education, can I say that? Or you've are connected with a busy street worldwide ministries. And we do have a new school out, and it's just started, and I'm going to be one of the instructors of the school to minister to you and help you understand your Bible better online. Bishop Forte wants us for the month of January to talk about the Bible, to give you an introduction concerning the Bible. In this teaching, we're going to take a close look at the Bible. And what I'm going to do is try to explain to you the origin of the Bible and the reason God gave us the Bible and the benefits that is in reading the Bible. I want you to really understand that, because if you're able to understand the origin of the Bible, the reasons why God gave us the Bible, it'll help you in your preaching and your teaching and in your reaching of souls. And I hope that you will enjoy this teaching. And at the end of the teaching, there's going to be some questions. And there's going to be some questions. I'm going to give you some questions. This is kind of new for me, so please bear with me. The word Bible, what does it mean? The word Bible was formed from a Greek term that means books. And it's plural, B-O-O-K-S. And it means more than one book. The Bible is a group of books that makes up one book. The Bible is, you can say, a collection of books that have been written by various authors. And what I like about the Bible is that the Bible flows. One author confirms another author. There's confirmation. There's no contradiction. Even though you have different authors, there's no contradiction, because the Holy Spirit is involved. Scholars say that the Bible was written by men who were inspired by the Holy Spirit. So therefore, you'll find that there's no contradictions. A lot of people will try to say, Pastor Tate, there are contradictions, but I haven't seen anything that would contradict the Bible, or where one scripture would contradict another scripture. In fact, is most of the time I tell people the best way to understand your Bible is to search for other scriptures within the Word of God to confirm a scripture. I tell them, I say, your best commentary is the Word of God. Now, you're probably wondering, well, Pastor Tate, why was the Bible written? The answer is God wanted to reveal himself to us, to mankind. And God wanted to reveal himself and his plan of salvation to Israel and to the believers that surrounded Jesus Christ. And also, you need to understand there needs to be a written document that could be passed down from generation to generation. And if you study the Word of God, you will find that the Word of God is fixed, is authentic, informed, so that it cannot be lost. Now, if you're listening to this teaching on my website, that's www.royaldiademministries.ning.com. If you want to become a member, all you have to do is, you know, when they're going to ask you who sent you, just write down Debbie, okay? And you can join our social website, because a lot of the teachings and our curriculum is going to be there. So this is, you know, and it will also help me grade your papers and help me to know that you understand the material that's being taught. The reason why the Bible is important for us and why we should study it is because it reveals to us the mind of God. The Bible contains knowledge of the will of God. And when I talk about the will, I'm talking about decision making. The Bible shows us the state of humanity. It shows us the terrible doom of sinners. And it also shows us the joy and the happiness of the saints. Now, when I say that the Bible reveals the mind of God, what I'm saying and what I'm talking about is that it reveals to us the thoughts of God. What God is thinking, what's on His mind. It reveals to us His personality, His character, His likes, His dislikes. In other words, I'm saying that as you read the Bible, you will know the will of God. You will know what He likes and what He doesn't like. And it's going to help you with your walk with God. And it's also going to help you to explain to others the Word of God and to guide them in the will of God and how they should live their lives. It also shows us what God has done for us, what He will do. And all of this is revealed in the Word of God. I can truly say that the Word of God reveals the mental state, the mind of God. And why am I saying this? It's because the Bible lets us know what God doesn't like. It shows us His mental state. It shows us his mental and emotional and psychological likes and dislikes. And it shows us God's spiritual condition. And what is God's spiritual condition? He's holy. He's perfect. We're not. We're flawed. So we know that the Bible reveals to us God, what God is thinking. What was His likes, His dislike, and His spiritual condition. He is holy. And believe it or not, and you'll see on two of the movies that I have on www.livestream.com, Royal Diadem Internet TV, and you can also find that on www.royaldiademministries.ning.com. You're going to see on the videos that I've put up two videos. Both of them are secular in nature. And you're going to see how men try to dispute the Bible. How they don't believe that the Bible is authentic. They believe because we're going to talk about King James. It is believed that King James had, I believe it was over 70 scribes or 70 people to rewrite the Bible because of the Puritans were complaining about the old Bible. Or they used to call, I think it was called the Bible of the Bishops. We're going to go into all that detail. We're going to put up videos of it. Some of the questions information that I'm giving you, I'm going to test you on it. But the Bible lets us know that God is a person. He's not an animated object. God has feelings, and the Bible shows us God's feelings. The Bible shows us that God gets angry. He gets happy. He's pleased. The Bible shows us this, and the Bible shows us God gets disappointed in us sometimes. And you know, these are emotions. These are feelings. And the Bible lets us know that God experiences these. The Bible shows us that God brings pleasure and that we can bring pleasure to Him by what we do and how we live before Him. The Bible also lets us know that we can grieve God's Spirit, that we can bring Him displeasure, that we can anger Him. The Bible shows us this, and this is why I believe the Bible is worth studying from Genesis to Revelation. The Bible is also a book of doctrine. It is a book of teaching, precepts, acceptable beliefs that are binding. Whether a person believes the Bible to be God's word or not, its precepts are still binding. What I'm saying is that regardless of whether you believe the Bible is true or fictitious, which you'll see in this video, whether the Bible, whatever you happen to believe, the Bible, whatever the Bible says will happen is happening. Whatever the Bible says will come to pass will come to pass. You will learn as you study the Word of God that there's power in the Word. And that cannot be debated. And I don't care how much they debate. They can debate till they're blue in the face. The Bible shows us that there's power in God's Word. There's power in the Bible. And you don't find this in any other Bible. on the face of the earth of any other religion, where you can literally speak the word of God and watch things actually happen. Like I said, whether a person believes in the Bible to be the word of God or doesn't, it doesn't matter. As you will notice in all the videos that were placed up on www.livestream.com Royal Diadem Internet TV, there appears to be a big debate on whether or not the Bible's true. And this debate circles around King James, the King James Version. And to me, it doesn't matter, because the point is this. As I said, just speak the word and watch the power of God work. That in itself lets you know that there is power in the word. There's no other Bible, as I mentioned, on the face of the earth that you can say that. You will find that as you read the Bible, that its history is true. Its decisions are changeless. You will find out that God is not doing a new thing, as some people will think that God is doing. God is just making us aware of the old thing that He's always wanted to do with us, and that is to have fellowship and communion with mankind. There's nothing new about that. He even told us in the beginning that the day that we took of the forbidden tree, of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, we would die, meaning we would lose communication, lose fellowship with God. In other words, God was saying, the day you disobey my word, the day you turn your back on me, dying, you will die. And that's what happens. We are dying. The Bible lets us know that God expects us to be holy. He has expected us to be holy because He's holy, even from the time that He created Adam and Eve. And we are to seek holiness in Him and through Him. So there's nothing new about this. What God has always wanted from us, He's wanted from us even in the beginning, even in the garden. The only thing the Bible does not tell us is how God's plans it gives us signs of His coming back again, but it doesn't give us a exact date. That's the only thing He doesn't share with us. He lets us know He's coming back again. He lets us know what the signs are, but He doesn't give us an exact date. But He does let us know that His main objective and the reason why He sent Jesus Christ to die for our sins is to restore us to our holy state that we were in when He created us in the garden. A smart person, a wise person, will read and study the Word of God to become wise, to become smart. A smart and wise person will practice the precepts in order to become holy. What do I mean when I say practice the precepts? They're going to practice holiness. And it's like practicing a piano or a guitar. Practice makes perfect. And the Bible is your instruction manual on how to obtain holiness and what to do. The Word of God gives us light to the believer. In other words, the Bible gives us information. It educates us. It reveals to us. It gives us direction in the way we should go. The Bible provides for the believer understanding by revealing its truths to the believer. The Bible frees man's understanding by revealing to him the truths that are in the Bible. What does it mean when the Bible says darkness? When people are in darkness, the Bible is saying they don't understand. They're ignorant. They don't understand between good and evil and living holy. They just don't understand it. They can't comprehend it. That's what it means to be in darkness. When the Bible says the God of this world has blinded, which means He has got their minds to a point where there's no clarification. They can't understand it. They're trying to understand it, but they just can't understand it. And this is why we're going to be studying about the Bible for the month of January. In this teaching, as I mentioned, we will take a close look at the Bible, Our objective is to explain the origin of the Bible. This is what the videos will do. We will also give you the reasons why God gave us the Bible, the benefits of reading the Bible, and our goal is that you enjoy the teaching and that you will learn, and you will have, if you have any questions or you want to send your term papers or your exams, send them to thecrowngem@yahoo.com. All right. Next week, what we're going to be talking about is I'm going to give you a brief overview of the Old Testament. We're going to talk about the five books, the first five books of the Bible, which tells us of the beginning of the Jewish race and its culture. Genesis is the book of beginnings. It describes the creation, the first rebellion against God, and God's choosing of Abraham and of his offspring. I want to give you a brief summary of Exodus, how God rescues Israel from slavery and Egypt and led them to the desert of Sinai. Then he gave Moses the laws to govern the new nation. Up until that time, there was no laws to govern man by. Then I want to give you a brief rundown of Leviticus. Leviticus is a book where God shows us how God set up his laws for Israel, and mostly regarding being holy and how they were to worship God. Then we have Numbers, and because of Israel's defiance and their disobedience, it is in Numbers that we see Israel having to wander in the wilderness for 40 years before they were able to enter the promised land. And then we have the book of Deuteronomy. Just before his death, Moses made three emotional farewell speeches, and it's recapped in Deuteronomy. He recaps the history. He warns Israel against further blunder. And notice that the word Deuteronomy, that name means second law. The first law was given in Exodus. So the word Deuteronomy means the second law. So if I were to ask you a question, I would say, identify to me the purpose of the first five books of the Bible. And your answer would be, the first five books of the Bible tells the beginning of the Jewish race and its culture. And then I would ask you, well, what is the first five books of the Bible? And you would tell me Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. I would ask you, what does Genesis mean? And you would tell me it's a book of beginnings. I would ask you, well, what is Exodus? And you would tell me that it's God rescuing Israel from Egyptian slavery. The word Exodus means to exodus. I will ask you, what is Leviticus? What does that book contain? You would tell me that God has set up laws for Israel regarding being holy and how they should worship him. If I asked you a question about what is Numbers, you would tell me Numbers is a book that talks about Israel's defiance, their disobedience, and how they were forced to wander in the wilderness for 40 years. And then if I were to ask you, what does the word Deuteronomy mean? You would tell me it means the second law. The first law was given in Exodus, and it's Moses rehearsing in Joshua's ear and recapping the history of Israel when they came out of Egyptian bondage. So I want you to memorize that, because those are going to be on your test. I'm Pastor Evangelist Deborah Tate, and I'll be putting up another video Wednesday. All right. God bless you. Selah.